Welcome back to the SMS Weekly Digest.
The Mouth of South.
We have a special episode for you this week. We are your anchors,
Mrs. Van Otterloo
and Mr. Morgan. So we've had a spring break to remember, and it would be easy to focus on, you know, the negative things going on, but we'd like for you to send in some success stories, some positive things that are going on despite the fact that we can't be together. The Digest is a way where we can stay connected and still feel like we're a part of the South community. So we'd like for you to send our videos, and we'll have some instructions throughout the Digest on how to do that.
And now, the weekly
Bagooder.
Did you know that while we're out of school, the Joplin School's Nutrition Services is providing breakfast and lunch for any child in Joplin? Well, it's true. Meals can be picked up at any school or any of the locations on your screen from 11 to noon every day. If you have any questions about meal pickup, call 417-625-5315. If you would like to sign up for meals, please follow the address on the screen.
Got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet, I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh.
Today we see teachers in their natural quarantine habitats.
Hello students, how are you? This is Mr. Mitchell. Hope you're all doing well. I got a few points that I want to make with you. One, help your parents out. You know, we've all got different things that we're worried about and that we're trying to take care of. They're trying to take care of you. So keep that in mind and help them out whenever you get opportunities. Do your part and chip in. And two, find a good book and read it. Parking the video games and getting off the computers and just finding an old paper book and reading it outside is good for you. Get a little sunshine and you're never bored with a good book. The third thing is that there's going to be a weekly update from me. They won't all be this long, but there'll be a weekly update from me in this format, and then I'll also do a weekly email starting tomorrow to students and to parents through PowerSchool. We'll get that information pushed out to you. Just a weekly update as to as far as what we know and what we don't know, what we're planning and how things are going. So I'll be getting information out to you about that. And finally, Wednesday, April 1st, the teachers reached out and they'd really like to do one of those parades where they just go through and see the kids. They miss you guys. I mean, bottom line, they want to be where they can see their students. So we're going to get out April 1st. We'll start here at the middle school and we'll just do a parade. They're excited to see you. I was surprised by the response from the teachers about the possibility of doing this, and they are just, they're all in. So that's a good thing. Students need you to be sure to be checking your email. There are teachers that are already sending stuff out to you, but there's a lot of information on your email. So if you're not checking that, please start doing that with some regularity, because your teachers will be reaching out to you. They'll be giving you information. There was a question about, is there going to be grades on all this? No, we're not going to have grades on this. There is a possibility for you to improve your grade standing. MSHA eligibility for the 2020-2021 school year. But this isn't going to be something that hurts your grades. This is just about getting better, keeping our skills up, and working on new content, continuing to learn, because you're going to be lifelong learners. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and sign off here. Everybody stay safe, and I hope you're all doing well. Eagle Pride, represent yourself and represent the community and the school as you're out working with other people, or as you run into other people, give a hand if you can.
is live in effect, and I don't waste time on the mic with a dope rhyme. Jump to the rhythm, jump, jump to the rhythm, jump. And I'm here to combine beats and lyrics to make you shake your pants, take a chance. Come on and dance, guys. Grab a-
hey, everybody. Just wanted to take a quick minute and touch base with the track team. Just wanted to let everybody know we're right where we were when we left for spring break. That season is temporarily postponed till the 24th, as school's been postponed until the 24th. Quick notes that means we are postponed. The season is not canceled, so there is a small chance that our season could still continue. Keeping that in mind, you need to try to make sure we're out every day training, doing some sort of activity. If you're not doing the workouts that I shared for the distance teams, those would be great for the sprinters too. Those are great workouts. If not, just get out, do 30 minutes of some sort of activity. Go shoot basketball, go walk, go jog, ride a bike, do something around the neighborhood. Seen several 7th grade girls teams that live in our area. They've been out biking and running. Key things to keep in mind. Those need to be done individually or in very small groups and no contact at all. You need to keep that 6-foot social distancing. Next, you need to make sure we're not doing those on school grounds. Anything that's done on school grounds, if technically caught by the state, could potentially hamper your ability to participate in a fall sport next year when school does roll back around. Also, make sure, have fun. Go out, do those workouts, have a good time, get out of the house, enjoy the weather. It's been nice. It'll help us get through this together. Next, shirts. Shirts are in. Coach Vickers went and picked them all up. Those that haven't already been picked up, she has taken a ton of time and has already labeled all those. We will be getting those out early this week. We will be hand delivering. When we hand deliver those, we will ring a doorbell, drop them on your front doorstep. You want to come out and say hi, that's fine, but we will not be actually handing them to you. We're going to set them on the ground and then take a step back. We are not allowed by district to actually hand them to you, but we will get them to you right away. If you have not paid yet, we're not worrying about it at this point. We will get money settled up after we get through all this and worry about it. If you want to mail checks to school, whatever, that's fine too. They'll let us know that they're in. But right now, we're just getting you the shirt. We will worry about payment on the other end. Cross Country has helped out, and we've paid for the shirts for those people that ordered through the Google Docs. So that's all taken care of. We'll get money later on. Next, uniforms. Several of you guys have uniforms. Season's still technically potentially on. Keep your uniforms. Don't worry about turning them in. Season gets canceled. We'll worry about all that later. We'll worry about turning it in even if it's in the summer next year. Right now, hopefully season's going to be on and we'll be good. Big thing is, we miss you guys. Take care of yourselves. Hopefully season gets going again. We get back in school and we see each other. If not, again, be safe. Take care of one another and we'll see you guys soon.
Hello, students and anybody who's watching the Weekly Digest this week. I have some words of wisdom for you. Find a good book to read. Play chess online with your friends or video games, whatever it is you do right now. Just try to stay positive and keep your chin up. That's what I'm planning on doing. So thanks and have a great day. Mr. Stats signing out.
Mein Liebe 300. Hey, South Middle School kids. First thing, wash your hands. That'll be the second and third thing, too. But fourth thing is, I do miss you guys. But I like to look at these little moments, these when life throws us these weird little curveballs, something that none of us have ever experienced before. I like to look at these as opportunities to try some different things and just maybe live a different way, which we certainly all are doing. Anything from school that you need to know from me is check your email, because incoming fifth graders, current sixth graders, seventh graders, I have an email out there, and I hopefully it's right this time to sign up for your electives on a Google form. This is a lot of what I've been doing on my off time here without you guys. This is my wiener dog, Jeff. So I thought that I would put him in this little clip for you all today. So please do email me. I've reached out to every one of you. I hope to hear back. Just give me a little idea of what you're doing. Wash your hands a lot. Stay safe. And hopefully we can all be back together pretty soon. I don't know. Maybe before we come back to school, we'll figure out a way that we can all see each other. Okay? Maybe. So, you guys stay safe. Wash your hands a lot. That's first, second, third, fourth. I miss you. I miss my visits from a lot of you regulars. I miss my group, my Interact kids. Johnny V, how you doing? Willow, Ellie, Hannah, Anaya, Dante, Shelby, what are you doing without all the candy from me? Anyway, I'll certainly have some for you if we ever see each other again. You guys take care. Bye.
The book I'll be talking about today is The War I Finally Won. It is the sequel to The War That Saved My Life. It is again about Ada. Her journey does continue into World War II. She is finally getting her foot fixed, and she's having a wonderful time riding Butter all the time. The only problem is that all of her friends are going off to the military to start fighting in World War II, and she's scared that soon Jamie, her little brother, will have to go to the war. It's a really exciting book. If you haven't read the first one, I obviously suggest that you should read it first. But it is a great, great story, and I suggest that everybody reads it.
If you're at home and needing something to read, there are a couple of resources that teachers and Mrs. Gilbreth have pointed out. The first one is openlibrary.org. You can go to openlibrary.org and find a lot of books. If you're having trouble kind of figuring out which to go, click on the Books We Love link, and you'll find a lot of books by authors for young adults. You can read Where the Red Fern Grows. There's a couple of Harry Potter books in here, Roald Dahl, C.S. Lewis. This would be a great tab for you to be able to access some books. Second, if you like listening to books, Audible has some free books right now. All you have to do is go to stories.audible.com, hit start listening, and then they've got it broken down. They've got it broken down for younger listeners, and then teens and tweens, and then literary classics. So maybe now would be a great time to listen to a classic that you've always been, I just don't have time to read this, or whatever. Those are available to you. Or you can check out the tween and teen library, where they might have things more like what we're used to seeing in the library. So if you have any questions, please reach out. And if you are ready to record a La Biblioteca, check out our Flipgrid. All you have to do is go to flipgrid.com/smswd.
What do you do to pass the time on an extended spring break?
What I did to pass the time to having our extended spring break, I worked out with my brothers and did homework.
What I do to pass the time when we have an extended spring break, I usually just sit in my room and procrastinate on stuff.
Now, the selfie second.
Here are some upcoming events. On Wednesday, all of us are going to get together and we're going to be driving through your neighborhoods to see you.
And we will be honking and shouting. I don't know that we'll be throwing anything based off of some parameters, but we'll be throwing hugs and hearts, but not kisses. And so you guys should just station yourselves outside your houses and we'll be able to have some face-to-face interactions.
Be sure you are checking your email. The district has ask that we as teachers send emails, principals send emails to communicate with you guys about what's going on, what's coming up, how you can keep learning while we're out of the building right now. We're still in school, we're just out of the building, okay? So be sure you're checking your email. For future digests, we are super dependent on you guys. So you can be a huge part of Future Digest. You may have seen it throughout today's episode, but we have a Flipgrid set up for you guys to help provide content for our Future Digest. All you have to do is go to flipgrid.com/smswd and you'll see multiple boards where you can add things like a La Biblioteca. You can add our new feature, Creature feature, and talk about your pets. You can answer the random question. There are so many opportunities for you to be a part, and we can't wait to see your videos because we miss your faces.
You can also email us at eleadersms@gmail.com. Also, don't forget to check your email every day. You're going to have messages from principals and teachers and the eighth graders if you're on Canvas, and a lot of times you'll probably be using that format. So stay attuned if you've got internet access and if you've got computer capabilities. We are going to be trying to continue as much of normal routine as possible. One other thing, get outside, enjoy the nice weather that we've had this past week, and hopefully upcoming weeks, be active, get some fresh air, like Mr. Mitchell mentioned, read a book, and try to keep some routine. If you can write down a routine and try to stick to that, that will be so helpful, I think, in the coming weeks. And I will also reiterate, as a parent, help your parents out. We might go crazy having to spend this much time with you all.
We miss you.
We love you, and we'll see you again.